The third part is where we look at the industrial chain. For 5G, its commercial speed will far exceed 3G and 4G. We have a data here in the 3G era. It took us from the deployment of 3G networks to the growth of 500 million 3G users worldwide. That is 500 million. It took 9 years. Of course, we know what the 3G era was based on, the promotion of smartphone terminals. We have achieved rapid user growth in the 4G era, from network construction to acquiring 500 million users. It took about 5 to 6 years. Of course, the rapid growth of users in the 4G era, what was it due to? The rapid development of video business. But in the 5G era, we predict the construction of 5G networks to reach 500 million users worldwide. It may only take 3 years or even shorter. This is the commercial speed of 5G. Actually, from some time ago, in October and November, looking at the numbers released by our three major operators, we quickly surpassed 10 million users from reservations. So because China is still a very large, the world's largest mobile communication market. So if the commercial use of 5G networks in China accelerates, the growth of user numbers will be very fast. Another point is the maturity of the terminal industry chain. Actually, in the early days of 3G and 4G, after our communication technology standards were frozen to the release of mobile phone terminals, it might take 2 years or even longer, but in the 5G era, from standard freeze to the appearance of the first mobile phone terminal, it only took 1 year, and it's our 5G network equipment. After gaining the ability to deploy on a large scale, commercial 5G terminals appeared immediately. Another comparison data, we will find the number of 5G networks. The growth is very fast. In the second half of 2018, there are already more than 30 5G network deployments worldwide. Actually, it has exceeded previous expectations. The previous expectation was 25, right? In fact, in the second half of 2018, we have exceeded 30 globally. A commercial deployment of 5G networks, so including the GSMA Association, right? They have all raised their predictions for the development of the 5G industry. So the development speed of 5G, the commercial speed of 5G is very fast. Whether it is from the scale of users or the terminal industry chain, or the speed of network construction, they are all very fast. At present, we know that the environment for large-scale commercial use of 5G is already available. Then we look at the end-to-end environment, including our mobile phone chips, including our terminals. It could be a mobile phone, or it could be this kind of CPE home or office use of this kind of CPE, including our wireless base stations, including our transmission bearer network, including our 5G core network. All these end-to-end network equipment and terminals are all mature than such a speed. Actually, it's a first in the history of communications. So we really find here the development speed of 5G really beyond our imagination. Compared with 3G and 4G, it will be very fast. And here is a Huawei, an end-to-end 5G product solution. Actually, from the terminal side, we can already provide such home or office use of this kind of CPE equipment. Of course, we have also provided a lot of 5G Huawei's 5G phones. Of course, Huawei has its own Balong 5000 5G baseband chip. Then comes Huawei's 5G base station. Huawei's 5G base station is mainly divided into two parts. One is the baseband unit that supports all systems, supports all 2G, 3G, 4G, 5G user baseband unit, supports our multi-mode. Then we have all kinds of this kind of video unit. We have support for this massive MIMO AAU. Then support this kind of ordinary, this 8-channel RRU. Then we also have support for this PRU deployed indoors. PicoRU, our small cell solution, of course, we will also have some of this blade type sites and these lamppost sites, because the number of 5G sites in the future will become more, because 5G uses higher frequency bands. So the coverage will be relatively worse. So we need more sites, and in the 5G era, small sites will become a very mainstream solution to meet various different coverage scenarios. Huawei has launched many products, this dense urban outdoor coverage. We can consider using this 3G MIMO AAU or this massive MIMO AAU in this subway tunnel scenario. We can consider using this ordinary 8-channel 5G RRU for this indoor environment, like this mall. Then airport high-speed rail station, those high-value indoor areas, we can consider using this small cell solution for this call hotspot area, like this pedestrian street. We can consider using this pole station, this lamppost station. In this way, the construction and deployment of this site is very fast. So this is Huawei's end-to-end 5G product is already capable of commercial use including our transmission bearer network equipment. We can go with the fiber optic transmission. If there are not enough fiber resources, we can also support microwave transmission, high bandwidth microwave transmission. Similarly, our core network virtualized platform and environment are also available. Can use our 19,000, can also use Huawei's latest Taishan series of servers. In this way, our entire end-to-end network equipment and terminal equipment are already commercially available, ready for large-scale commercial use